So the image is made up of this sort of thing happening for every single point on the object. Well, let's see if we can actually do that with a real object and make an image of it. Take this down. I'm going to turn the table. And here we have Ernie. Oh, that's bright. And we're going to move Ernie back here a little bit. Cool earring, Ernie. So light is coming out of Ernie, it's coming out of the lamp here, bounces off Ernie and passes through this lens. And those of you who are right in line there can maybe see a hint of an image of Ernie somewhere in there, right? So it looks like when you look through the lens, you see an image of Ernie. But where in space is it? Well, it turns out we have this piece of frosted glass, and all it is smooth on one side and rough on the other. So wherever, if we somewhere in here find an image of Ernie, if we put our glass right there, we should be able to get it nice and in focus. And let's try to do that. Oh, there's, you can actually see this better with the room lights down a little bit, I think. But we'll try it. So there it is. Like I said, there's a nice image of Ernie in focus right about there and upside down. So that means there's a place in space right here where all the light that came off of Ernie went through the lens is reassembled into an image of Ernie. So when you look through the lens, you're actually looking at that image right, you're seeing that image right there. The light is apparently coming from that image in space. So there's a real place in space here where we have an image of Ernie. We're going to use that some more. Now we call the distance, turn that off for the moment. We have this distance O from the object to the lens. And we have our focal length now. And we're going to need to eventually calculate the distance to the image. So depending on where we place the object relative to the lens, the image can end up at a different place. Now, in this case that I've drawn, it's at about twice the focal length. In this case, the object further away from the lens, the image ends up being closer to the lens. Again, we can see that with Ernie just by moving him closer. We'll move him here. Now move the light so that it's shining on Ernie, bouncing off and creating an image of Ernie, which is now here somewhere, I think, right about there. Right about here. So we've moved the image. It's bigger. Still upside down. Now we have to figure this out, right? Mathematically. Where the image ends up depends on the focal length, the distance of the object from the image, from the lens. Now, we need to think about this a little bit. Remember, all of the light that's coming from the object, like Ernie's nose here, let's think. That light's going out in all directions, and it's all hitting the lens. And then it gets reassembled into Ernie's nose out here somewhere, right? Nevertheless, when you look through a lens, it looks like you can't escape the impression when you look through a lens that the image is actually on the other side of the lens somehow, that somehow it's over there. But it's not. The image is here, and what you're seeing is the light coming from here. In that direction. Now, on the other hand, this light, this lens is not infinitely big. It would be fun to have a really big lens, but that's very costly. And the bigger the lens is, the more places you can stand and see the image. So if I'm over here, I can't see the image of Ernie, right? I mean, there is an image there, but I can't see it because the light coming off in this direction from Ernie didn't make it through that lens. We'd have to need a really big lens for that. So that's the way you have to start to think about seeing, actually seeing the images coming from lenses. Now, you also saw that when I didn't have the screen right where the image was, it appeared fuzzy, out of focus. That's what we mean by an out-of-focus image. One of the things that's also true, and we can leave this set up. You could come by after class and look at it, or when you're in DL, you can try this yourself. But the image, if I look at the image is never out of focus. I have good glasses, first of all. And the image is here. And it doesn't matter where I am. The image knows that it's in focus. The image is focused at this point, okay? You don't have to adjust anything to see a focused image through a single lens. That's another important point. So maybe it's obvious, or maybe it's subtle, but give it some thought. Now you say, I thought that a lens like this, which has got spherical surfaces, convex, is a magnifying glass, right? We just showed that if we move the lens to, you know, really far away, let's try that one, quite far away from Ernie, what happens? I think the image that we get is clearly smaller than Ernie, right? That's small. I thought this is a magnifying glass. Doesn't a convex lens make a bigger image? Well, not always. Not always. And we'll have to calculate that. Now, in the case that we've drawn here, we have the object here, the parallel ray coming in is bent like that. If you put your eye here, it looks, and look at the image, it looks like the image is twice the size of the object. So yes, a converging lens can be a magnifying glass, if you will, but it doesn't have to be, as we'll see. It can make images which are bigger or smaller than the actual object. In this case, the object has to be a distance less than O, distance O less than F from the lens. And again, we'll use Ernie and try to do that. We'll move the lens close. We'll move Ernie close. Try not to melt Ernie. That actually happened a few years ago. And then let's find, where is Ernie? Hello, Ernie. You're somewhere, I know it. Oh boy, I put them too close, I think. Let's try that. There. Nice big upside down Ernie. I hope you can all see that. How about like this? There. Should I turn off the room lights again? I think it's worth it. There you can see a nice big, there's a big Ernie in there somewhere, okay? So here we've made a larger image just by changing the distance of the object and the lens. Okay. To do this calculation, we won't derive this equation. You could actually derive it geometrically using the just using rulers and so forth, but we'll just declare that the thin lens equation is 1 over O plus 1 over I equals 1 over F, where O is the distance from the object to the lens, I is the distance from the image to the lens, or from the lens to the image, and F is the focal length of the lens. We're going to use this equation quite a lot. So in the example where we made a magnifying glass out of our lens, we have, let's say, a focal length of 10 centimeters. The object is at 5 centimeters. And in this case, the thin lens equation, I think you can pretty quickly verify, gives that the image is equal to minus 10 centimeters. Now notice that you get a negative sign here. We have to be very careful of our positive and negative sign convention. I less than O means the image is in front of the lens. And we're going to make that very clear. Also notice the following thing, that it doesn't matter where your eye is. Your eye can be anywhere. I just happened to draw it here. But your eye doesn't even have to be there. There's still the lens makes an image of the object, even though your eye may or may not be there. Now, this isn't an image you could project onto a screen, like we did with Ernie. If we put Ernie too close to that lens, we can no longer have the image on that side of the lens. Now, we're going to also call, we're going to say the lens has a front side and a back side. The front side is the side that the light goes into, and it emerges from the back side of the lens. So that's the front of the lens, and that's the back of the lens. You're only going to be able to see any image if your eye is on the back side of the lens, right? I think that's also pretty clear. Some of this is obvious when you think about it, but you know, when you try to do it using the equation and using all the terminology, it might not be so clear. Okay, so let's just do a clicker question using the lens equation. I'll give you plenty of time. You can talk to your friends, write it out, do the solution on a piece of paper. For a convex lens with focal length 20 centimeters, to get an image at I equals minus F, the object must be at what? So I urge you to do this algebraically rather than just cramming numbers in right away.